I have the pleasure to meet Ramon Sastre. As some of you already know, Ramon is the director of the Parametric Design and Architecture Master's Degree.
Pardon, sir.
And has been a former director of this school of architecture. Apart for being a mentor for several startups here in this school, like SMIA or CODA. It's a pleasure to meet him, mostly because students from the previous year of the master missed this opportunity to meet one of the greatest specialists here in Spain on topics about membrane, structural analysis, tensile architecture, solar radiation analysis, and many, many other topics. I think that probably he's like, we've always talked about him as a pioneer because he's a singular figure that combines his role as an architect, but also as a programmer and computational designer. Ramon, it's a pleasure to welcome you.
Well, thank you. For me, it's a pleasure also to be here in my school, so it's not a very different from other occasions. But I'll try to adapt my lecture or my speech to what it should be. It's a part of the Master of Parametric Design in Architecture. And today we are going to talk about lightness. That was the title, and I put another one, lightweight design, because in English, light sometimes is the light. And when you say light and heavy, it's very clear, but when you say only light in architecture, can be difficult. So many times we use the word lightweight. It's longer, but it's clear. Well, lightweight, why? I put here four answers, and then we will see another picture. Some other answers that can be more. Well, easy to transport if it's lightweight, easy to manipulate, less structural impact, less ecological impact. All these things are clear. And probably that's the reason they used. Well, we don't have any real picture of Colosseum shade. But we have text about it, so we know there was something. It was like this, probably not, but something was done in the Colosseum to provide shade. And actually we have, nowadays we can find high mass in the North African desert, tipis in America, and yurtas in Mongolia. Well, in this case of yurtas, the membrane is not structural. It's just the roof and the walls. The structure is another thing. And here we see the motorbikes. So the transport is one of the reasons they use this lightweight construction. And besides the why, how we make lightweight construction? Here we have two bridges. One is a water bridge, Pont du Gard in France. And another one is one of the bridges in Istanbul, Bosphorus. And you can see the difference of the size. And the reason is one is in compression and the other one is in tension. So we can get the lightweight of a building through different ways. Through the density of the material or through the way the structure works. Here we have three real examples I calculated. It's very simple. You have to support 1,000 kilos. And if you use a cable in tension, well, remember, but just a parenthesis, tension in English is tracción in Spanish. not tensión in Spanish. That's something important. So in tension, you need just this section of cable, 1 meter long. If you want to use a column, a tube, for example, you use this tube with this section. And if you want to use a bending, a beam, you need this tube with this section. But if you make it longer, let's say 10 meters long, section of the cable is the same, exactly the same. It doesn't change. But the tube now is 30 centimeters, square centimeters, and the bending 18. So it changes the order. But this one is always the same and smaller. So that's one of the reasons we use tension in lightweight structures, because everything is smaller. And it doesn't matter, in a way, it doesn't matter the size. We can change sizes. That's something very, very dangerous when you change sizes in compression or in bending, the model to the real thing. But intention is, it doesn't matter. It's the same. It's exactly the same. Well, if we want to use lightweight materials, here we have a table of densities. Well, the gold is not a construction material, but it's the heaviest, more than lead, more than lead. Fortunately, we don't use it. But we don't make buildings of polystyrene foam, for example. So materials are heavy, more or less, of course, from balsa to lead. There is a lot of difference. But we look about bricks or stones or steel or anything like this. Is 4 times, 5 times, 6 times, but similar. So the way to get lightweight buildings is more due to the way of the structure works than to the material we use. Membranes are light. Yes, a lightweight, because they are very thin. And they are very thin because they are under tension. So that's why we can get roofs with a very low weight, but very, very, very low weight. In a pneumatic structure, the weight of the roof may be 1 kilo per square meter. One. That's something impossible with other material. Well, in this lecture, I will present you two persons very important in this world. One is Bert, the other one is Fray Otto. And then I will show my work. It's not so important, of course, but it's my work. I know very well, and I can talk profoundly about it. Well, Bert was an engineer that worked, as in many other new inventions, worked at the army, or for the army, not the for the army, and then after creating some domes for the radars, he thought it could be interesting to make buildings with these pneumatic structures, and created Bert Air, which is a firm that still exists nowadays, very important one. And they have made many of the big membrane buildings in the world. This is the O2, the Millennium Dome in London. Here, again, why? Not why lightweight buildings, but why tensioned membranes? It's practically the same. And here you have a list of reasons. So using tension membranes generally means having something very lightweight. Even a long bridge like the one in Istanbul we saw. Of course, this is not membrane. Steel cables, and you have the pavement of the road, which is a normal pavement with concrete, with anything, asphalt, anything. But it's lightweight compared with any other bridge. Well, Berter also created a new material. It was a membrane made of fabric or glass fiber fabric covered with Teflon, PTFE. This is nowadays one of the best materials. It's a bit expensive compared with other materials. It's more difficult to manipulate, to create big membranes. But for example, this is one of the membranes that Berter constructed in 1973, so more than 40 years, and is still nowadays working. So these membranes nowadays will take more than 50 years or practically 60 years, so that's a life for a building. Fraiotto is another thing, is a European architect engineer. He also arrived to this field of lightweight construction for other reasons, but mainly for ecological reasons, we would say. So he had the idea that we could use less materials to construct things. And one of the most important things that Fraiotto did was to create an institute for research, the IL. IL was an institute in Stuttgart related to your university, and they managed to attract the most interesting researchers in the world. So many people went to Stuttgart to do research there. And they studied many things in nature, they make models. Well, you have to think that when Bert or Otto started, there were no computers. Well, there were computers. But computers were, when you imagine the memory or the RAM of these computers is 1 million less than nowadays. 1 million less than nowadays. So computers were not used. They made models, they studied models, and they used computers for some formulas, from some equations. But in fact, the practice was important for them. Here we have a model of the Olympic Stadium in Munich, and they used this model to study the structure, or more than a study, to recreate the structure. They had studied the structure in normal way, and they checked with these models, mainly the formations, and they had to study which is the importance of the moving from a model to the reality. But remember that intention, this is less important. It's important, of course. The models of deformation of these models is not exactly the same as the real material, but it's just a transfer of model of elasticity, not the whole thing as in other materials. He was also a pioneer in studying soap bubbles. Well, they studied a lot of things in nature. Egg yolks, soap bubbles, and leaves, anything they could find. And in this case, they discovered, or they knew, that the soap bubble takes a shape which is minimal, because in this way the energy is the less. And finding a minimal form was interesting, but this is a mathematical concept. What is a real for architecture is if the soap bubble is always in tension, always in tension. So if you build something like this, it will be in tension. In tension at the beginning. At rest, when you put snow or wind on it, is another thing. But at least when you create these forms, they are in tension, which is not easy, and which is the reason why we use the form-finding concept in this type of architecture. So we have to find, we have to search for the form. Not any form is possible. And nowadays, still there is a misunderstanding about this. Working as an architect that works with other architects, sometimes I receive forms made with present software that they think can be a membrane because it's something folded like this. Well, not all forms can be in tension, not all forms. And finding these forms is something important. And in this case, the soap film gives us automatically a tension form. Well, another, for me, very important thing is EL produced a lot of books, a lot. Here we have 41. So most of the researchers that joined the group in Stuttgart, they wrote a book. The book was in German, Japanese, in English, in many languages, mainly these three languages. And you can find, it's difficult to find these books nowadays because they were produced by themselves, and some of them are exhausted, so you cannot find in the bookshops. But it's possible to find, it's possible to photocopy it. So generally there is a permit to do it because there is no other way to get it. Well, EL, when Fareto died 3 years ago, has changed. Now it's called ELEC, but more or less tries to continue this work of research connected to the real world of architecture or engineering. Well, now some works of Fareto. One of the biggest was in 1967, the expo in Montreal, in Canada. They made these structures. It was something completely new. Well, nowadays, if we look at these buildings, well, this one is not, they don't exist anymore, but in Munich we can see the buildings. We find it modern, something new. Well, it's 50 years ago. So 50 years ago, they did this thing. It was completely new at that moment, something strange. That was the reason, because they got the commission of creating this roof, or different roofs, for the Olympic Games in Munich. Well, this building has not changed its icon representation. It still attracts many people to see it because it's something different. Sorry. Well, like here the membrane is not a real membrane, it's a cable mesh. It's a cable mesh, and over the cable there is a roof of transparent plastic. But that is a roof, it's on the mesh. What is structural is the cable mesh. In some buildings there are membranes inside, but are for the sun protection or something like this, not structural. Well, that was before. This is also an icon in Köln, in Germany. In fact, they changed the membrane recently because the membrane was very old, and the membranes of that time, 57, last century, were not as good as present membranes. So they changed the membrane, but they made exactly the same thing. Well, Fareto not only worked with membranes, he worked with lightweight construction. Another type of lightweight construction were these timber grids. These grids made with timber, they were very interested not only in creating forms, but in building them. So that's the reason, because all this roof is made with timber that has a hole every 50 centimeters, all the roof, except, of course, at the border. The border they have to cut to create the different arches to enter and have the access. And here these beams, you can see these wooden beams here to receive the membrane. But the membrane is very, very, very simple to construct. Very simple to construct. Well, he used the negative hanging form. Always you find Gaudi here, but Gaudi was not the inventor. Another one who used this type of creating forms. And finally, at the present time, we can find very strange things in this world of membranes. So not anymore is it interesting to create that forms that were interesting 50 or 20 years ago. Now I pretend to, many times pneumatic structures, but other times just tension structures. But the object, the form, is more interesting than the real use of the structure. Well, up to here, what is important. Now I'm going to talk about my experience in this world. I would say that everything started in 1975, 1 year later of this book. I had just finished my studies, and the translator of this book was a colleague of my course, and he told me, you that like a structure, we have to work with these things. I had no idea about Fraiotto at the moment. Well, I knew that was something in Munich, done for the Olympic Games, but 3 years ago, not so far, but nothing else. This was a book that existed. This is the PhD thesis of Fraiotto, and it was translated to Spanish also in 1958, but I had no idea of this book. So I only knew this one. And we started to try to build something like this. We made many designs for membranes, for free, of course, just to try to get one commitment. And at the end, this was our first membrane. The picture is very bad, but it's the only one I have. I'm sorry, it's the only one I have. And when I see this, I say, how badly designed is it? But curiously, after 15 years, the owner was so glad with the membrane that they changed the membrane and they used the same project, the same patterns with it. So what was stupid? But they did exactly the same. Nowadays it doesn't exist because this building was put in a place that was not allowed to construct. It was, I don't know how it is in English, no, a precario, no sé cómo se dice. Yes, so you construct in a place, but you know you cannot construct, so the time they say you have to remove the building, you have to remove it. So nowadays it doesn't exist. It was by the beach in Castelldefels. And a year later, we had the opportunity to build a very big thing, a very big thing. It was a pneumatic structure in Sabadell. There was a swimming pool, 50 meters swimming pool, and another one for jumping. This is the interior, so we constructed all the wall, all the glass wall, the roof, and all the ventilation system, which is another something very complicated. With pneumatic structures, you have another thing, which is the pressure, and you have to deal with the pressure. Well, this roof should be mounted and dismounted every year, summer and winter. And you can imagine with this thing here, it's very complicated to mount and dismount. We had to put some zips on the roof. And I remember very well this idea. We decided to continue these lines vertical at the end. So it means to create patterns in that way, with no computers. So everything was made with the geometry we learned at school. So intersection of a spatial curve with a plane, vertical plane, and find the points, and then to create the distances, and to create the patterns. These are the zips to open the roof and put it down and up every year. Well, after 15 years, more or less, they changed the membrane. And they decided to remove this thing here and to change the form, not so high, because the volume you have to warm in winter is much bigger, so put it down. This is the roof. Well, you get a lot of water when it rains, and you have to. And this is the wall with it, with concrete. And we used the old building to fix the other side of the roof. Well, nowadays it doesn't exist, this roof, because the old building was obsolete and was broken practically everywhere. So not the new thing we did, but the old part. But in fact, they made a new covered swimming pool, much new, much better than a membrane one. That's the things we used to fix the structure. Of course, we have to justify that the forces of the cable, which are very, very, very big, were good for the structure that existed. And, well, when we finished this building in 75, 76, more or less, we knew that we had done something which was not good. We had no idea about these big buildings, and we did it. Just we were very young, and we did it. So I decided to learn, not to do things, to learn. I decided to make a PhD on membranes. Unfortunately, at that moment, there were few people who could teach us membranes. Practically no one in Spain, a few in Europe, but they didn't want to show you anything because they learned their life with the knowledge, with the software, with everything. And it was like a secret, so it was very difficult to get knowledge about these things. But finally, I made my PhD. And this form is not created by the computer. Well, it is created, the coordinates, by the computer. But there was no printer, no plotter, no screen. You had to draw everything, line by line, to create these forms. That's one of the reasons my PhD has a very few images. And some of them are pictures taken from other books, because, well, this was the beginning of my software. The software was called TESS, for thesis, for tension, for a film, a Polanski film of that time called TESS. So many reasons I put the name TESS, but only numbers. So you can see only numbers. And with these numbers, you had to draw these things. With the numbers, you had to draw these things. And to create the patterns. And I made a model, my PhD made a model, small model, with patterns. Because generally we use models with Lycra, which is very easy to create a model, but with patterns, real patterns. Nowadays, TESS has evolved, has changed, now is a commercial software, and it's called WinTest because it was translated to Windows, although it is also a Mac program, so it, well, but the name is WinTest. And Win is also something with, related with the wind, and can have an idea. And making patterns is much easier. So you make a pattern in seconds. And when I did the first project in Castelldefels, I remember it was half a day. So I could do two patterns in one day. Two patterns in one day. Well, the moment that the software arrived, the real software, not as today, because now the computers are much better, but 30 years ago started some software to be popular. Something happened. I don't know if that's the real reason, but in many schools in Europe, there were many teachers inspired by Freyoto's work that did things. And you can find, when you move around the schools in Europe, some models, dusty models because they are forgotten, about membranes. And suddenly, all these things disappeared. I don't know why. Maybe the teachers retired, is a possibility, and the other and the new ones were not interested in these things, or because nowadays if you don't have a software, you can do nothing. If you are a musician, you need software for music. If you are a doctor, you need a software for medicine. If you want to work with tensile structure, you need a software for tensile structure. And this software is very expensive because there are a few users for it. It's not AutoCAD. Millions of users. No, no, no. So you have dozens of users for a software. For example, the one I would say is the best, at least the best known, is a suite of software. It's about 40,000 euros. So that's something serious. So you, not everyone can buy the software or can use the software. Only big firms that make big stadiums can buy the software. Other companies use their own software. For years, it was normal what I did. You need to create your own software. That was normal because there were no software in the market. So many firms have their own software and they work with their own software until the one who did retires, and then the software in a few years is obsolete because the OS changes and nothing works anymore. Well, one of the first things I did with my new knowledge was a shade for my van. I had a van and I made a shade for the van. It was something interesting, and I remember in the campings everyone looked at the new thing. Well, this is the picture I used to show this presentation. This was a very interesting project made in 2000 for the restaurants at Port Olympic in Barcelona. So the town hall obliged to all restaurants to have the same type of shade for all the restaurants, because they had these umbrellas, but all were different, and there was a chaos, and they decided to create this. Well, it was something very complicated, because who makes the project, who makes the commitment, who creates the membranes, etc., etc. Well, finally, they decided to use a firm, and this firm was one of the firms I worked normally, so we made this project. Unfortunately, one of the main points of this project was something that could be open and closed summer and winter. And nowadays, no one opens in summer. They have air conditioning inside, and they keep it closed all the year round. So it's very difficult to see one of these open, but every module can be open. They can be opened. And of course, it was much more expensive due to that, because you had to organize all the rollers, everything, to move the roof. This is another example made without the possibility to open it. So, this firm created a very nice model, a very expensive one, but everything was perfect. It did not seem Spanish in this sense. And it was very expensive, but they sold some of these objects around. And finally, they made just fixed roofs, because it's much easier, much simpler, and much cheaper. This is again the Port Olympic. And I have no picture which is open. Everything was well designed and constructed, so the water gutters for the membranes. This from inside. Here you can see the support, but this is a roller support, it can move. We had the opportunity to create an aluminium profile. I never anymore had this opportunity. If you don't want a lot of kilos of profile, you cannot create a profile. But you created a special profile for the water, for the rollers of the both sides, for the rollers of the structure and the rollers of the membrane, which are different. So everything was done specially for this project. This is the profile, and there is a finish at the end, not to see all the holes of the profile. Well, this is the ventilation, These are the rollers, the structure rollers, and the membrane rollers. So there is a catalog with all the pieces. So when you see this, I never seen the same in my life in Spain with the projects. So everything is done more or less. In this case, everything was perfect. Well, the arches, as you can see, are two tubes that they opened to stabilize the arches. When they are open, when they are closed, it's not necessary. But another point were the foundations. I want to pay attention to the foundations. Foundations is something, light structures, lightweight structures are lightweight, what you see. But what you don't see, it depends. In Munich Stadium, the foundation, the supports of the main cable on the border of the roof are houses of concrete, solid concrete, under the earth. So it's very complicated to support all these tension forces. So a lightweight upwards, not downwards. In this case, well, the payment was already done, so we had to do something very easy, and at the end we created a kind of hand pour, let's say, to stabilize the column of the... Here you can see another one of the structure. Well, the idea was to put again the pavement, and you don't see anything. You don't see anything, but here you have these elements with an anchorage at the end of each element. So there's an anchorage. An anchorage to where? To some place that you have something to pull, not to the earth. Well, I don't know if it's going to work. Here I have a video, it's not too long, if it's too long we cut it, of this membrane. This is in Malaga, and here you can see the importance of the foundations and of the way of thinking how you are going to build the membrane. Because these are negative umbrellas, and you have to put the membrane from the top. Well, here are the beginning of foundations. Transport, of course. Folding the membrane is very important. You have to fold it, that you know how it is folded, because when you unfold it, it must be in place. You cannot unfold and start to moving the membrane, no. Here are the foundations again, the same type of foundations. Look, the membrane is already on the floor. He has not seen, maybe you will see it better in another one of the umbrellas. Here you see the membrane on the floor, and now you put the arms. Well, when you use galvanized steel, you cannot weld anything, so everything must be with screws. Well, it's too long, we can cut it because... Well, with lightweight construction, something very interesting is that the building, it takes a few days, so many times one day, And every day you must finish something. You cannot leave the membrane just during the night. You must finish things every day. Well, you can imagine the end is this. Tallo. Sí, perquè és un mateix. Well, this is another project here. The same year in Canary Islands, there's a bus station, and it was a very huge paraboloid which the lower points cut. So you don't have 4 points, you have 6 points, because For every low point, you have two here too. Well, in this case, when something is very big, it's very important to think about the size of the details, because you see something there is small, but when you see the real size, it's very, very, very big. You can imagine here things, the size of the things. Well, here, this is a cable. That's something important. We say the redundant structure. It means it is possible that the membrane breaks for any reason. Even for vandalism, someone can, with a cutter, can cut the membrane. It's important that the columns don't fall without the membrane. And that's the reason we have a cable here. But this cable is not seen. You don't see the cable. Cable is there, but people don't see the cable. You can paint it blue if you want to confuse it with the sky, but it's not necessary. Well, this is only one picture. It's something curious because we made this project in 1995 in Barcelona. It was a double, sorry, a double conoid, but without column, so the high point is supported with a pyramid. That's the inside. Where there is a column, it's stupid because you see a column. But okay. And when they took this thing out, it was again in this condition, it's constructed in a place that cannot be constructed, and sometimes it must be removed. They decided to transport it to another place. That's something curious. You can do it. You can use the same structure and put it in another place. And this is the second life of this membrane. Something different here. It changed a little at the beginning, but they have to cut and change the membrane here. But practically, it was the same everything. Well, this is another, a very interesting project, because we spent much more time thinking how to construct it but how to design it. So we had to cover for a, it was a temporary roof, a very short temporary roof, 1 week. That's a political reasons, it's stupid. But we did something that can be used again, like the one before, but they never used. It's a problem, so they never used. It could have used it in another place, easily. Well, this is a castle in Mallorca. It's a very curious castle because it's a round castle and a round yard. And they wanted to cover this round yard for a week. Well, on the roof of the castle, there's something that can be visited. And here there's a parapet, but the parapet is very, very small. So people cannot get there. There is a rope just to protect. And in the middle of the roof, there is this element, which is the main wall that arrives to the top. So this is the main wall, because the inside, you can see there are some columns. So the main wall is this one. In the yard, there is a well, and this well has a structural thing with a spire here just in the middle. So you cannot put the membrane on top of here because it will be broken. And around the top, there is this small roof with tiles that is very easily to be broken. And we had the problem that the property of the castle, which is the public castle, didn't like to build anything there. So we were not allowed to make a single hole, nothing. You can do nothing at all. So I said, that is impossible, because we would need a lot of sand to make the counterweight. And they said, how many? How is much sand? Well, 1,000 bags. Well, 1,000 bags. So they did it. Well, we brought everything from here, all galvanized steel, so no welding there, no welding at all. And they built this thing on the main wall, that's the main wall here. And it's just with wood, with timber, just resting on the wall. Not hole at all, no connection, nothing at all. Then we put these bands. This is the parapet. As you can see, it's very, very simple. So it's very dangerous to work here. We put these bands. That's very easy, because you take the band here and someone goes around and you put the band, you put these bands. On top of these bands, we create, here connected everything with small elements. And everything worked, and we closed the ring. It was a surprise, but everything worked. And then on these elements, we put this membrane. This is a perforated membrane, so if it rains, theoretically there's no problem of ponding, because the water will fall down. And we can walk on this membrane. So now it's very easy to build anything. You can walk here, it's like it was flat. And at the end, we remove this membrane, and everything is done. So this was the membrane. The membrane was a cushion, something inflated. It was packed, and we knew very well how it was packed. So we put here, and started to open the membrane. These guys are floating and walking on the roof, pulling the membrane. Well, inflating the membrane takes about half an hour or something like this, and you must take a moment that the wind is not going to be strong, because now it moves a lot. And finally, it was inflated. Well, this is the responsible of the castle, that at the end was very happy, because we made no hole, nothing at all. We didn't break anything. These are the sandbags, the 1,000 sandbags for the counterweight. Now they are retiring the constructing membrane and these bands also. And that was it. So it was very easy to take all the structure and put somewhere and inflate it again, but they didn't use. This is a special thing, because it's again, let's say, a quality membrane structure, which is not normal. Generally, membranes are very, they say, very cheap. No, that's not true. They are not cheap. They are expensive. But are used for, in this case, it was used for a building, for a restaurant. Is a double membrane, a different color membrane, everything well done, with precision. And I am going to finish with two special projects from the AZC from France, from Paris. It's a team of architects specialized in strange things, let's say. And they won a contest with this trampoline bridge. The idea was to put it in the Seine in France, in Paris, but it's very complicated, because when the water moves, it's more complicated than when it's quiet. They didn't think about this. But I say that because some things have been done about this project, but all in lakes or in ports where the water is still. Well, this was the idea, and they arrived to one Spanish constructor of membranes, and they arrived to me, and we started saying that this, which is very simple, because it's a symmetric form, very simple to be done, this is unstable. You cannot float easily, so this is unstable. We convinced them to make something flat, because otherwise it's very complicated. It can be done, but it's very complicated. And we convinced them to create a small model. The original model is 30 meters size, and this was 3 meters size. In the middle of the ring, there is a membrane. This membrane was also here designed, but this membrane was not a tensile surface. It seems, but it is not. So you have to adapt a real tensile surface at the level you want and to create this. Well, we try to do one part rigid and one part here very deformable to jump. That's the model. We checked the model in a swimming pool. So, and this is the architect of AZC. But this time it was not possible to jump because it was very small. Well, they were very satisfied with the model, and they decided to create a new, bigger one of 10 meters. It was possible to use it to jump. Well, we made this model, and this time there were 4 sections to jump. Not the whole area. The whole area is very, very difficult because everyone is going to the center. So all will follow at the same point, so it's very dangerous. Well, this manufacturer is very close to the Banyoles Lake, and we go to the lake. Here we inflated the thing. It's the same, but bigger. And here we had the opportunity to test. Well, there were a lot of children, school children there, and they were loving to jump on the model. These were the children. They came here and they jumped. Well, finally, we put it in the water. And then also other people jumped, but not the children of the school for responsibility. So other people jumped and it worked. Well, that was a very curious thing. And it was the reason when they had another commitment, the same team of architects in Paris, they asked again us to create this thing in London. Well, I received this email a few days ago from a student asking me how this was done and how we deformed the tube. Well, I explained that we didn't deform anything. It's not like this. This is very rigid. You cannot deform it. Very rigid. You have to create the form with the patterns. So the secret are the patterns. You create a tube with the patterns, and when you inflate, you have the form. There's nothing, no secret. Well, when we did this element, we created all the elements, all the patterns with geometry again. Fortunately, nowadays, we have tools for geometry. Not as many years ago, that everything has to be drawn by hand. But it was created single pattern, every pattern with geometry. So when they had the second commitment, I said, well, that's not the reason. We have to do something automatic. I don't know if ever I will have another project like this, but we created with the software, a part of the software to create automatic patterns for these things. So this is the pattern. You have a line. You decide the diameter of the tube, the number of the points for every ring. You can use a polyline imported for the XF, or you can create a membrane with 28 points here. Here you have the length, etc. And once you have this, with a few seconds, 1-2 seconds, you have this. you have all the patterns automatically. So of course, it takes a long time to produce the software, but then you can do any form. Because, but unfortunately, there has not, no other commitment about tubes at the moment. Well, this was the model they had. Again, we had a problem that this surface has not to be a tensile surface. Maybe or not. In this case, it was not. So if you make a membrane like this, you have wrinkles because it's not under tension. So it's not so easy to create surfaces in tension. You have to create a form under tension. The tube is inflated, so it works. Well, we created a model, of course, a real model, before starting. And we had to create the membrane, a new surface for the membrane. In this case, it was used with transparent PVC. And these lines pretend to symbolize these lines here. They are not exactly the same form they wanted, but they like it so. Well, once it was checked, it was transported to London. Well, you have to fix, of course, these things, because otherwise the wind will move it. And it was a temporary attraction. I don't know how long it was in London, but maybe 2 months or 1 month, I don't know. Here you can see a little the roof in the workshop at in place. And of course it was an attraction. They can jump on the tube. Fortunately with barefoot, otherwise with shoes is And that's it. Thank you. You have any question, of course?
What was the budget of the last project you showed us, the inflatable, like more or less? How much does it cost to build a temporary structure like that?
Well, that's very difficult because you cannot use the normal relation per square meter, because this is something, is a tube.
Yeah, well, that precise project.
Yeah. Well, generally, you can imagine that a square meter of membrane, manufactured and transported, it can be about from 100 to 300 euros square meter, depending on the complexity of the project. So from 100 to 300, more or less.
I have a question regarding the lifespan of the membranes. Because you often mention that every 15 years they have to change the membrane.
The old membranes, constructed 30 years ago. Present membranes nowadays, well, nowadays we use mainly three types of membranes. Transparent with ETFE, it can take for maybe 40 years easily. If you don't touch it, if you don't remove every year and mount again, so that's true. The PVC membranes, PVC covering, because the fabric is made of polyester PVC, which is the cheapest and the normal one. A good membrane nowadays would take more than maybe 30 years maximum. If you don't remove every year, and it's okay. And fiberglass PTFE, I would say more than 60 years. That's the time for good membranes nowadays, yeah.
And how about the recalibration of tension?
That's something that unfortunately, yesterday I had a meeting with one of the manufacturers here in Barcelona, well, near Barcelona, and they say that users the forget about the membrane. They construct the membrane and they forget. And after 20 years, it's broken. Well, of course, it can be many reasons. Well, we see that nowadays we have tornadoes even in Spain. that's something of the change of the climate. Of course, we cannot do anything with this, but it's impossible to create a membrane that stands in a tornado. So for sure, it will be broken. I don't know if tornadoes will go being more frequent every time or just from time to time. But when you have strong winds, generally the membranes get loose. So they are not in tension. And you have to re-stress them. It must be done after 1 year or after the first good load, heavy snow or strong wind. And then maybe every 10 years, not often. But you have to check if it's, it has to be done. But you don't have to do anything special because you prepare things, you go with a machine and you can stress anything. So it's very easy to do it. But the thing is, nobody does. Well, nobody. The main buildings, stadiums, all these things, they have, of course, a better care of the buildings.
Did you have in mind at the beginning that you are creating a software company, or did
No, no.
No,
For many years, I worked as an architect designer. Although for many years, architects didn't exist in membranes. So membranes was something that a manufacturer did, and the architect did not exist practically. Only in a few cases. And I had my software. But I worked for many manufacturers. So many manufacturers asked me to use the software for themselves. And I told them it was not prepared because I worked with the software and it was a problem I changed at the moment. So nowadays, there are still many main manufacturers in the world that they work this way. They have their own software and they change when necessary. But well, I started to rent the software to some firms here in Spain until in 2011, so 6-7 years ago, I decided to commercialize it. Well, you must start to create all the help, all the web page, everything, because there was nothing. You cannot sell a software with nothing. So even these users at the moment, they use the software without any instruction. So I started, and after some years, I decided that I could not sell a software and teach and create the software. So I sold, let's say, the rights of the software to a company that commercialized it. So I don't commercialize the software. There is a company that commercializes and just create the software. I update the software every moment. But it was a surprise. No, never thought about creating a company and selling software. No, never. Well, thank you very much.